So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to make a shiny Magikarp plushie. So obviously you can use this method for a normal Magikarp plushie and just change the colours, but basically this was a commission that I had, and this is a really difficult and challenging plushie to make. It took me a very long time to do. There's a lot of embroidery and stuff on it, and I'm still sort of practicing and learning with that. But anyways, I thought I'd make this video anyway, even though it's a commission, because I thought, you know, Magikarp's quite a popular Pokemon. Hope you enjoy this video, and thank you very much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Okay, so to start off with, you just begin cutting out your patterns. I just want to take the time to apologise that I've got yet another cold. I seem to catch them really easily, so sorry if my voice sounds really weird in this voiceover. So for the patterns for Magikarp here, I was testing out a new pattern. So what I actually did here was cut out four of these sort of oval patterns. But as I was working along, I realised that these were made the Magikarp too round. So you actually only need to cut out two of the oval ones, and then you'll need like four like thinner oval shapes, which I've attached a picture of the patterns in the video now to make sure that you get the right shapes. Top and bottom fins of the Magikarp, I use this lemon yellow fabric. I suppose when you Google shiny Magikarp, you get different kinds of colours when it comes to like the shiny Magikarp, but I just picked one picture where it sort of had a few different colour variations in it, which I preferred. Obviously, if you're using this for like a normal Magikarp, you use the normal Magikarp colours. If you haven't already, you need to get yourself a pencil that can draw on fabric, and therefore be like it can rub off of the fabric once you've sort of drawn on it, but you just need to draw out the kind of scales the Magikarp has, and there's like a line towards the back of the Magikarp as well. Take note that the pointed end is the back of the Magikarp and the sort of the flat end is the front. So now what you need to do is you need to use your sewing machine to embroider on these scales. So I'm still quite new to it, it's not the neatest embroidery obviously, but you just need an embroidery foot on your machine and set it to the zigzag stitch, and just go along your lines, sort of going over your stitches to make it as neat as you can. It's really time consuming, it's quite fiddly. If you prefer, you can just paint on the scales because it would be quicker and it might be easier. Next, cut out two white felt circles and pin them down in place for an eye. Embroider that circle onto your yellow piece. Okay, so what you need to do is like pin all the curved edges together on the sort of oval pieces and just leave like the ends with the flat bit open where it should create a little circle there. Everything needs to be soft side down, just so you don't forget that when you turn it inside out, the soft side will be on the outside. So for the fins, just pin the soft sides together. Same with the top and bottom, lemon yellow fins. And the tail pieces and the sort of the yellow edges for the fins and the tail. And then once you've sewn up all together, you can turn your pieces inside out. And this is the part where I realised that the Magikarp's body was too round, and I edited it off camera, but I changed the pieces for you guys so that you should have what I have. So just stuff the big Magikarp body and the top and bottom fins for now. Pin the top and bottom fins down to the top and bottom of your Magikarp. And make sure that they are like central to the sort of top and bottom of the Magikarp. Because you've got two pieces on the top instead of just that one round piece, there's a line going through the middle so that you can accurately see where to place the fin. So what I do for the fins is I pin the yellow bit to the fin and ladder stitch it down. Once it's ladder stitched down, I will then put the stuffing into it. So I just leave a hole in the end of the fin, which I'll ladder stitch up once it's been stuffed. So I show you how to do the ladder stitch in my how to make a base plush video. You might want to trim some of the yellow edge if it's too thick. I deliberately made the template thick just in case, but trim it if you would like. Pretty much use the same way to make the tail. Embroidery now. Magikarp has some lines on his fins and tail, so just use the same embroidery method to embroider on these lines onto the tail. If you find it easier, you can do this part before you put the yellow edge onto it, because it might make it a bit easier. Next, you can start to ladder stitch things down. So the fins on the top and bottom of your Magikarp are the first thing I choose to ladder stitch down. Next, you take your pink circle for the mouth that you cut out and just ladder stitch it, closing up that gap. Then sew down the tail and basically then the fins. So you're just basically attaching all the pieces to its body. Coming up to the final stages now, going back to the lemon yellow fabric, I cut out three strips, one that I sort of wrapped around the mouth area to see how long it needed to be, one that size, and then two the same size which are for the little kind of whiskers that he has underneath both eyes. So once you've cut out long rectangle strips like that, just fold them in half soft side down and sew along that edge, turn inside out and stuff them. So the shorter one of the three pieces, you just wrap around that edge where Magikarp's mouth is, and I sort of put the ends together at the bottom of the mouth, and then you pin that down and you ladder stitch that on. The other two whiskers just pin underneath his eyes and also ladder stitch that on. I go around a few times with these to make sure they stay securely in place. And finally, the little tiny dot in Magikarp's eye. I just paint this on because Magikarp doesn't have very big eyes at all. And then with that, your Magikarp plushie is done. So this actually took me a very long time to do due to all the embroidery. The commission information is over on my Facebook page if you're interested. If you just want requests for tutorials, that information is over on my Patreon. I get a lot of people asking me to make certain people and I can't do that all the time. I'm really sorry about that, but thank you very much for watching. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you ever make this plushie, feel free to show me, and I'll see you in the next video.